Πάτερ ημών, ο ενδυσουρανής, αγιαστήτω το όνομά σου, ελθέτω η βασιλεία σου, γεννηθήτω το θέλημά σου, ως εν ουρανώ και επί της γης. Τον άρτον ημών των εμπιούσιων, δώσ' ημίν σήμερον, και άφεση ημίν τα οφειλήματα ημών, ως και εμείς αφίεμεν τις οφειλέτες ημών, και μη εις ενέγκυς ημάς εις πειρασμόν, αλλά ρίσε ημάς από το πονηρού. Αμήν.
Obviously, you need a new financial advisor if you're losing money like that. My name is Bill Manolopoulos. I'm a certified financial planner. Αυτό θέλει να πει ότι έχω σπουδάσει για το financial planning. Το financial planning δεν είναι μόνο το investments, είναι και την ασφάλεια, το retirement plans, taxes, estate planning, education planning. Είναι πολλά πράγματα. Δεν είναι μόνο το investments, επενδύσεις, με το χρηματιστήριο. Εγώ δουλεύω με τους attorneys να κάνουν το estate planning. Δουλεύω με το accountants να κάνουμε το taxes, να είμαστε σίγουροι ότι ό,τι κάνουμε είναι για το καλό για εσάς. Συγγνώμη για την ελληνικά μου, όμως προσπαθώ να
μιλήσω.
Το estate planning είναι to make sure that the assets pass to the right people the right way, not the government's way. Because then you're going to pay a lot of taxes and it's going to go to the wrong people. The documents that the lawyers will speak about, obviously, what I do is I help you organize. We put up a plan, we go to the lawyers, and they draft the documents according to your plans. Of course, they're going to have their own suggestions, but at least we have a plan in place to move forward. You can lose a lot. You can lose a lot, and it could be very costly if you get sick. Retirement plans. For those people that have 401ks, για αυτοί που έχουν μαζευτεί για το 401ks, το annuities, pensions, όλα αυτά, πρέπει να έχεις κανένα ένα plan όταν κάνεις το σύνταξη. Ξέρω άτομα που πάνε σε κάποιον, ας πούμε σε μια τράπεζα, σήκωσες όλα τα χρήματα, ας πούμε 500.000 δολάρια, το σήκωσες και τα έβαλες κάπου αλλού που δεν ήταν σωστό και τώρα πρέπει να πληρώσεις το φόρο. Φέρει το IRS. Δώσ' μου το taxes. Και χάνουν πάνω από 30% τα χρήματα που έβαλαν μέσα. Αυτό είναι αλήθεια που έχει γίνει. Και μάλλον ξέρεις κάποιος που έχει κάνει τέτοια πράγματα. Το άλλο είναι το investments.
Speak in English because your Greek is not so.
Alexiou's office, Century 21, on 23rd Avenue. You have my information on the tables. You can give me a call, and we can have an appointment, whatever you like, and discuss your particular situation. Do you have any questions? So a whole life is a policy that you have for your whole life, that you have for your entire life. That policy is designed to take, it's to get a little bit complicated, but it's designed to be there for your whole life. Generally speaking, it's going to be more expensive, but it will definitely be, as long as you pay the premiums, that policy will be in place. It used to be sold that you could sell, you put the premiums for 15, 20 years, 17 years, something like that, and then you don't have to put the premiums anymore, and that, you know, you have money saved up. In a sense, that's true. You do get dividends because you're participating in the company's performance. However, it's not a guarantee. Term life is, as it says, it is for a term. So you have a set amount of insurance, so it could be $100,000, $1 million, whatever it is. It could be for 10 years, 15 years, 20 years. Well, when you take that money out, you're going to get taxed at the highest tax rate. So if you're in the 30% tax rate, you're not getting the 3%, you're getting 2%. So that's the highest tax, that's the problem with those types of investments. Now if you do, for example, municipal bonds, New York municipal bonds, no federal taxes, no state taxes, no city taxes. Triple tax free. So if you do dividends are from stocks. So you're not going to invest in a risky stock, but you know, you invest in a nice, what you're going to pay is 20%. So even if you're in the 35-40% tax bracket, you're not going to pay more than 20% in taxes on dividends. Now, of course, you want to invest in...
Πει περισσότερα πράγματα γύρω από το θέμα που αρχίσαμε και αν μπορεί, ας μας πει και εκείνος, αν έχει υπόψη του, μερικά πράγματα για life insurance in late stage of life. Ναι, η κατάσταση εδώ. Σπύρος Κεζερμής, τα είπαμε και τον προηγούμενο μήνα. Έχω το αφεντικό μου εδώ, Norman Samuth. Τη δουλειά την κάνει 30 χρόνια, μου έχει μάθει ό,τι ξέρω. I'm telling him, you taught me everything I know. So, πώς θα το κάνουμε, θα πείσω τον Norman να μιλήσει, θα μιλήσει στα αγγλικά, δεν είναι Έλληνας. Και εγώ θα απλώς λέω μερικά πράγματα στα ελληνικά.
Yes. Okay? Yes.
Και όποιος έχει απορίες, σταματήστε μας, για να μην πολυλογούμε και φεύγουμε από το θέμα και έχετε κάποια απορία που θέλετε να λύσετε. Εντάξει. Okay. So you started off, and I'll just jump in Greek once in a while, and I told them if they have any questions, tag team, exactly.
Good evening. Good evening. My name is Norman Samuth, and I do not speak one word of Greek, except I know Christos Anesti. And if Spiro told you I taught him everything he knows, and if he does, that's only because I was lucky enough to have a good student.
Thank you.
So I'm an estate planning attorney, and what we basically do, my job is to help assist you in getting your assets to the people you love while denying Uncle Barack and Uncle Andrew as much of your assets as I possibly can. How many people here have ever heard of something called the estate tax? Well, a couple of people, okay. So the estate tax is a tax that the federal and the state governments impose. So here's the way it works. You work hard all your lives, right? You take all kinds of risks. You invest and you buy a home, and you have to deal with things like floods and hurricanes. I live on the South Shore of Long Island, so we had to deal with a hurricane a few years ago. Right? You take all those risks, you go through life, and then when you die, the federal government makes a decision. They say, are you too wealthy? And if they think you are too wealthy, they take a piece of your money. So after you spend a lifetime paying income taxes, capital gains taxes, if you smoke tobacco taxes, if you drink liquor taxes, taxes when you sales taxes, real estate taxes, school taxes, sportsmen's taxes, and there are literally hundreds of other taxes that are built into the things that you buy that you don't even know about. So if you actually have the nerve to accumulate wealth after paying all those taxes, the government has its hand out again.
A month.
So the question of who's going to pay for it is significant, is it not? Because, again, you've worked hard all your lives, you've saved up your money, you like to pass it on to your loved ones if you can, right? So there's three ways you can plan for what happens if I have to go into a nursing home. The most common thing that people do is they self-insure. Do you know what that means? That means they did nothing. And they took the risk that if they have to go into a nursing home, they're going to pay for it. That's what most people do. Most people do no plan. Right? By the way, how many here know Prince died, right? The singer, Prince? Right? Now, this guy, he was loaded, okay? This guy's multi-millionaires. You know, he died without a will.
Yeah.
And now his family is fighting over his estate. Okay? Really very sad. You know, sometimes I think I should send these people a letter, you know, just, yeah, I'll do your will for you, you know, because you should at least have a will. Anyway, so the first thing is you can pay for it yourself. Now, if you're really wealthy, if you're Donald Trump, you're not worried about it, okay? But, and if you're really poor, if you have nothing, you're also not worried about it because the government pays for it. But if you're in the middle class, which most of us are, this is a huge expense, and if you don't deal with it, you may pay a very high price for that. So, what's the second way we can cover the cost of a nursing home? There's actually something called long-term care insurance. Has anybody ever heard of that?
No.
Okay. Hey, one person all the way in the back. Okay. And what it does is you pay a premium
to an insurance company, and the insurance company takes the risk, including his right to own your house when you die. If they go bankrupt, that interest in the house can be sold to satisfy debtors' claims. So, generally speaking, bad idea. Because what we would want to do